An AWOL soldier has been arrested in the United States, accused of planning an attack on serving men and women at the Fort Hood military base in Texas. Joining us with more is our US correspondent Daniel Sutton. Dan, explain to us exactly what this guy was planning to do.
Well, this 21-year-old was apparently plotting an attack on the very institution he was committed to serve, the US Army. According to police, he wanted to blow up or shoot dead serving personnel at the Fort Hood military base, the very place where just 2 years ago there was another shooting massacre. But as you'll see from this story, it was a retired local police officer who ran a gun shop in the area who saved the day.
Army Private Nasser Abdo, an AWOL soldier accused of plotting to blow up his military comrades.
I would classify it as a terror plot, yes.
The 21-year-old was arrested last night at this Texas motel. In his room, police found gunpowder, dismantled shotgun shells, timers, and a backpack containing extremist Islamic material, a gun, and a shopping list for bomb ingredients.
He's a very dangerous individual, and he's where he needs to be.
His intended targets were soldiers at the nearby Fort Hood military base. Police say he planned to blow up a local restaurant where they ate and drank. Abdo has a history of issues with the Army. Last year, he refused to fight with US forces in Afghanistan because of his Islamic faith.
I don't think I'd be able to live with myself if I deployed.
The alarm was raised by the owner of a gun shop where Abdo tried to buy six containers of smokeless gunpowder.
The first red flag is when he asks Kathy, what is smokeless powder? If you don't know what it is, why would you buy 6 pounds of it?
That gun shop is the same one used by Nadal Hassan, the Army major charged with the 2009 shooting massacre at Fort Hood, which left 13 dead and more than 30 injured. Police believe today they've stopped another murderous attack and in the nick of time.
This press conference we're calling today would have been a lot different.
In the United States, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.